Hello, good morning everybody. Today we will discuss about that paramecium, which is the protozoan animal, protozoan specimen. The first we will discuss about the classification: phylum protozoa, class ciliata, order holotricha, and genus is the paramecium. That paramecium, it is also called as the ciliate protozoans because of the cilia which is the present all over the body, which is used as a locomotory organ, and because of it is also called as the ciliate protozoan. It is also called as the slipper animalcule. Simply, why it is called as the slipper animalcule? Because its shape, it look like the slippery shape, and because of it is also called as the slipper animalcule. The particularly posterior, this one is the anterior end, this one is the posterior end. If suppose we observe, this anterior end is the blunt and the posterior end is the pointed. And particularly at the posterior end, there we can see that the cilia which is present all over the body, but at the particular posterior end, that is the larger in size, that's why it is called as the caudal tuft of cilia. Then we will discuss about that the structure. So first is the external structure. That external structure, pellicle, this paramecium is bounded by pellicle, which is the double layer, thin and elastic type, and the made up of the gelatin. Simply, it is the double layer, the outer layer which is the continuous with the cilia, and inner layer which is connected with the ectoplasm. Cytoplasm again divided into the ectoplasm and endoplasm. This is outer area, that is called as the ectoplasm, inner area that is called as the endoplasm. So ectoplasm contact with this cilia, this pellicle. The function of this pellicle is nothing but it holds the shape of the animal, but it's elastic to permit the contraction. Simply, you have seen that jelly type ball, when you have contract as the rubber, simply when you have contract, it gets to the return to the original position. Likewise, it is likewise the pellicle function, it holds the shape of the animal and also permit the contraction. The second is the cilia. So simply we can observe that cilia which is all over the body, which is the present. That small hair like projections on the body surface, that is called as the cilia. Each cilia which is arise from the basal granule or the kinetosome. Then this particularly cilia which is, we can see that this is the basal body or kinetosome, and from this basal body then cilia gets arise. If you have seen that the particularly all these cilia all over the body, they are uniform in the size, but particularly at the posterior end there is the larger in size, that is called as the caudal tuft. Function of that cilia is nothing, just we can assume that simply we observe that paramecium, the function of that cilia is nothing but the, it is act as the locomotory organelles. The particular function, structure of that cilia, there is the 9+2 arrangement, 11 microfibrils are which is the present, 2 in the center and 9 in the periphery, which is the double ring structure, and 2 which is in the center, that is the single ring structure, that is called the 9+2 arrangement. The function of this cilia is nothing but the organelles of locomotion and food collection. It is also act as a sensory receptor and detect the stimuli of the external environment. Then next is the internal structure. Simply, internal structure again which is the cytoplasm, again divided into the ectoplasm and the endoplasm. That name indicates, ecto means which is the outer area of the cytoplasm, endo means inner area of the cytoplasm. Then ectoplasm, which is the clear periphery, and it contains the trichocyst, which is, you can see this trichocyst just after the pellicle, and infraciliary systems are present. Infraciliary, that name indicates beneath infra, just below the cilia. Simply, we have seen that the cilia which is arise from the kinetosome or the basal body. So simply, it is related to that. We will dwell upon that infraciliary system. Then endoplasm, which is the large granular central. It include like all these cell organelles, Golgi complex, mitochondria, ribosome, then contractile vacuoles, which is the present, and the food vacuoles, and also the nucleus. First is the intracellular system. It just located below the pellicle. Intracellular, just below the pellicle. It consists of the basal body or kinetosome. We have seen that. Kinetosome or the basal body, from that the cilia are arise. This is the basal body and kinetodesmata. This is the kinetodesmata. Means they have that the basal body connected with each other with the help of that kinetodesmata. The wall of basal body consists of 9 fibers with 9 plus 0 arrangement. Now seen that in case of the cilia, how there is the microfiber is present, 11 microfiber, and arrangement is the 9 plus 2. In case of the basal body, simply there is the 9 plus 0 arrangement. The function of this intracellular system related to the cilia. What is the function of cilia? Cilia, it act as a locomotory organ. So simply the function of intracellular system is nothing but that it controls and coordinates the movement of cilia. Next is the trichocyst. Simply that trichocyst, which is just below the pellicle, lie perpendicular to the right angle to the axis, and simply that is the spindle in shape, which is present just after the intracellular system. What is the function of that trichocyst? It is nothing but they serve as an organelle of defense, and they may be for fixing the animal to a spot during the feeding. Simply we can see in this diagram, this is the paramecium, this is the didymium, which is the prey. Simply they have released the trichocyst to fix that spot, that is nothing for the feeding. And also if suppose the any enemies are comes to near the paramecium, and they are hazardous, they have think that the paramecium, it is think about that is the hazardous, that is the enemy. Simply at that time the trichocysts are released. Next is the endoplasm. Simply in the endoplasm, cytosome simply which is the present, through that oral grooves, then vestibules, and this is the buccal cavity, and then after that here is also the cilia which is the present. That is because of that the larger molecule, it is goes not inside the body, it is goes outside the body, and this is because of the cilia. Then that food molecule, it is enter through the body, enter inside the body through the cytosome, and because of that cytosome, it is also attached the cell mouth. Nucleus, simply we can very clearly see there is the two nucleus which is the present. One is the larger in size, kidney shape, and second is the smaller in size, which is the present in the depression of macronucleus. Macronucleus or the meganucleus, which is the larger in size, micronucleus, which is the smaller in size, and that is the spherical in shape. In case of the macronucleus, that is the kidney shape. Not only the shape and size, but also the function is also the different. In case of the macronucleus, the function of that macronucleus, it controls the day-to-day metabolic activities. And in case of the micronucleus, simply it controls the reproduction activities. Listen carefully, that is very important point. In case of the, as a point of examination, in case of macronucleus, they have controlled the day-to-day metabolic activities. Micronucleus, they have controlled the reproductive activities. So simply, if you think that, this is the point. Now, paramecium also survived without. Paramecium also survived without which nucleus? Macronucleus or micronucleus? Function, micronucleus is the reproduction. Macronucleus function is the day-to-day metabolic activities, and micronucleus only the reproductive activities. So simply paramecium also survived without the micronucleus but fails to reproduce. Next is the contractile vacuoles. Simply, the contractile vacuoles, which is the present, one is the anterior end, second is the posterior end, two generally which is the present in the dorsal surface. Each contractile vacuole is connected to the 8 to 10 radial canals. Simply, that is the empty canals, and that is the full canals. And ultimately, when the pulls and then it is goes outside, that is nothing but the water. And if suppose we observe anterior and posterior, this one is the posterior, they have more rapidly contract as compared to the anterior one. The function of that, simple, they collect the water and then it exhaust outside the body, simply water balance. So main function of that contractile vacuole is nothing but the osmoregulation, and also it helps in the removal of carbon dioxide and other metabolic waste products to the outside. So simply excretion. Next is the food vacuoles. Numerous food vacuoles which is the present, that name indicates. Simply, we have seen that there is not the digestive system which is the present, means likewise the mouth, pharynx, esophagus, that is the unicellular animals. How there is the respiration, digestion, all these metabolic vital activities is takes place. So because of that, simply small cell organelles are present and they have play their vital activities. In case of the food vacuole, simply there is the food is goes and then there is the digestion is occur. So food vacuoles, which is the, they have collect the food vacuoles, or also it is called as the gastroles. That name indicates the function is that simply the digestion. Next is the paramecium. We will discuss on the paramecium in next lecture. So thank you very much.